PG-13. Starts Wednesday, December 18th.
You lose. I win. You lose again. I win. You lose. This is getting ugly. Oh no, my batteries are dying.
Yeah!
Presenting our longest lasting Energizer Max ever.
This is a test of the State of Wisconsin Emergency Alert System. This test is now concluded.
Hours a day,
every day.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Verizon Wireless.
This is a test of the emergency alert system.
Exclusive Shame on You reports only on 19 Action News.
The National Weather Service in Wilmington has issued a tornado warning for Logan County in Ohio until 8:45 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. At 8:02 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, National Weather Service Doppler radar indicated a severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado near Lakeview, or about 12 miles northwest of Bell Fountain, moving east at 30 miles an hour. Locations in the path of the storm include Russell's Point and Bell Center. A tornado watch also remains in effect until 10 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time Sunday evening for Ohio.
Meteorologist Steve Prince of Valley here with you.
By Outback Steakhouse and Duraco.
A severe thunderstorm warning has been issued for your area.
What's more deadly than the winds, waves, and rain of a hurricane? It's called storm surge.
The big death events have occurred in surges. Tremendous loss of life.
The effect of wind on the ocean pushes a mass of water towards the coast. The water, sometimes as high as a house, rushes ashore with terrible violence.
All my life, I mean, Camille has put this kind of effect on me.
Emergency alert has been activated. Please tune to Channel 5 for further details. Thank you.
Georgia's story shows how hurricanes live and die. All hurricanes start over the sea, Hispaniola. When it hit land, as we can see from its track, the hurricane lost intensity. But each time, George made it back over water, where it refueled and strengthened. When a hurricane moves over a continent, it's on its way out.
With some tips for surviving the elements.
The same cone twice on the same mark.
We interrupt this program to activate the emergency alert system at the request of the National Weather Service. A flash flood warning is in effect through 12:30 a.m. for north central Lincoln County and northeastern Elbert County. Locations in the warning include, but are not limited to, Lyman and the town of Agate. The public reported flash flooding from a thunderstorm 6 miles northwest of Lyman. Water was reported be 4 feet deep over the exit at mile marker 354 on Interstate 70. In addition, Big Sandy Creek was already running half full, and River Bend Creek was bank full. The storms with the torrential rain were moving northeast at 15 miles per hour into northwestern Lincoln County. This concludes operations under the Colorado Emergency Alert System. All broadcast stations may resume normal operation.
I decided enough is enough.
Dates from around about 1900 or 19.
Wonderful. The National Weather Service in Melbourne has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for eastern Indian River County in Florida until 3:45 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. At 2:49 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, National Weather Service Doppler radar indicated a severe thunderstorm capable of producing nickel-sized hail and damaging winds in excess of 58 miles an hour. This storm was located 3 miles northeast of Ellesmere and moving southeast to 10 miles an hour. Other locations in the warning include, but are not limited to, Sebastian, Vero Lake Estates, Vero Beach South, Vero Beach Highlands and Gifford. Severe thunderstorms produce damaging winds in excess of 58 miles an hour and or large destructive excessive lightning and very heavy rain will also be possible. If the storm approaches you, seek shelter in an enclosed building on the lowest floor. Keep away from windows. In Florida until 3:45 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. At 2:49 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, National Weather Service Doppler radar indicated a severe thunderstorm capable of producing nickel-sized hail and damaging winds in excess of 58 miles an hour. This storm was located 3 miles northeast of Ellesmere and moving southeast to 10 miles an hour. Other locations in the warning include, but are not limited to, Sebastian, Vero Lake Estates, Vero Beach South, Vero Beach Highlands and Gifford. Severe thunderstorms produce damaging winds in excess of 58 miles an hour and or large destructive hail. Frequent to excessive lightning and very heavy rain will also be possible. If the storm approaches you, seek shelter in an enclosed building on the lowest floor. Keep away from windows.
One, here is another in the One series.
We have a little clip to show you.
I'm so lonely.
Push her back.
Your attention, please. This is the Alberta Emergency Public Warning System. The following emergency bulletin may affect your area. Listen carefully.
This is Brian Proctor, severe weather meteorologist for Environment Canada. At 5:10 p.m., Doppler radar is tracking a rotating severe thunderstorm near Drayton Valley that is moving east at 35 kilometers per hour. This dangerous storm is likely producing very large hail and may produce a tornado over the next 30 minutes in areas from Drayton Valley east to Carnwood. Persons in these areas should be prepared to take shelter immediately in a basement or reinforced structure if a tornado develops. Get low and put as many walls between you and the storm as possible. Stay away from windows, doors, and outside walls. If you are on the highway and cannot avoid the tornado, seek shelter in a ditch or ravine. To repeat, a possible tornado is developing near Drayton Valley and is moving east at 35 kilometers per hour. Persons in and around Drayton Valley east to Carnwood should be prepared to find shelter immediately.
This emergency warning message has been broadcast for your safety. If your area is affected, take all necessary precautions and listen to any local radio, television, or cable outlet for further updates. Do not use your telephone for the duration of this emergency.
With our tasty chocolate sensation sundae or choice of fresh summer salad.
Good morning, Krusty Krew.
Hey, Patrick, you all ready for the big night out tonight?
Yeah, it's gonna rock.
Are you ready to go crazy?
I'm already hearing voices.
Are you ready to...
SpongeBob, Patrick, do...
Go and you sit down, and I had the burger because I wasn't a big barbecue guy at the time. I have
to this night all week.
Party!
What do you think we should do first?
What should?
All right, in just under a minute, millions of Americans will witness history. For the first time ever, the government will launch a nationwide test of the emergency alert system. It's designed to allow the President of the United States to address the country within 10 minutes from any location at any time. The system was not used on 9/11, which some critics say proves the U.S. is still living with an outdated warning system. So, if you're watching television or you're listening to the radio, you are about to hear it. We're told it will last just 30 seconds.
1370.
Test of emergency alert system capabilities. This test message has been initiated by National Alert and Warning Authorities in coordination with emergency alert system participants, including broadcast, cable, satellite, and wireline participants in your area. Had this been an actual emergency, the attention signal you just heard would have been followed by emergency information, news, or instruction. This is only a test. We now return you to regular programming.
Take on the severe spending cuts necessary to pull Greece out of its debt crisis. In other news, legendary Penn State football coach Joe Paterno says he will retire at the end of the season. This comes as his former assistant coach Jerry Sandusky is charged with several counts of child rape. Paterno released this statement. Here's what he says. It says, quote, "This is a tragedy. It is one of the great sorrows of my life. With the benefit of hindsight, I wish I had done more."
Issued a tornado warning for Anderson County, Knox County, Morgan County, Rowan County until 9:45 p.m. At 9 p.m., National Weather Service Doppler radar indicated a severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado 5 miles northwest of Kingston. Doppler radar showed this tornado moving east at 55 miles per hour. Locations in the warning include Oak Ridge, Clinton, Knoxville, Oliver Springs, Dearmond, Carnes, Powell, Norris, and Halls. In addition to the tornado, this storm is capable of producing golf ball size hail and destructive straight line winds. The safest place to be during a tornado is in a basement. Get under a workbench or other piece of sturdy furniture. If no basement is available, seek shelter on the lowest floor of the building in an interior hallway or room such as a closet.
Use blankets or pillows to cover your body, and always stay away from windows. If in mobile homes or vehicles, evacuate them and get inside a substantial shelter. If no shelter is available, lie flat in the nearest ditch or other low spot and cover your head with your hands. A tornado watch remains in effect until 11 p.m. Friday evening for southwest North Carolina and East Tennessee and southwest Virginia.
Over northern Douglas County and is now moving up through Aurora with all the heavy rain that we've had this past week. And bear in mind, from the Stapleton area down towards southeast Aurora. And again, I'm gonna go ahead and delete that severe thunderstorm warning that was allowed to expire. So now we're just dealing with the flash flooding that is going on. And we do know a lot of folks were concerned about the sirens going off in Aurora a little bit ago. City of Aurora tends to do that. They fire off the sirens. They have not reported any official tornadoes. The Weather Service never had a tornado warning out for Aurora. So again, that's the City of Aurora shooting off the sirens. Perhaps that was in response to the flash flood warning. We're not sure.
The National Weather Service in Denver has issued a flash flood warning for western Arapahoe County, southwestern Denver County, until 7:15 p.m. At 4:21 p.m. Mountain Daylight Time, trained weather spotters reported flash flooding and torrential rain in the southeast sections of the Denver metro area. The storms producing the rain were moving slowly to the north and northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Up to 2 inches of rain have already fallen in the Aurora area, and similar amounts can be expected in 30 to 40 minutes as the storm moves in. Some locations that will experience flooding include Denver, Aurora, northeastern Lakewood, Centennial, northeastern Littleton, Englewood, southeastern Wheat Ridge, Greenwood Village, Sheridan, Arapahoe Park, and Buckley Air Force Base. This expands and supersedes the previous warning that was in effect for western Arapahoe County only. Precautionary preparedness actions. Excessive runoff from heavy rainfall will cause flooding of small creeks and streams, urban areas, highways, streets, and underpasses, as well as other drainage areas and low-lying spots. Turn around, don't drown when encountering flooded roads. Most
good. So give me that name again. And Becky's with us from South Metro Fire. Becky, where are you and how are you guys handling this?
Well, I am at home right now. We're trying to get people to stay off the roads. We are going on multiple calls of people stranded in their cars because of high water on the roads. The Parker corridor is one area up Arapahoe. Wherever there's low area, there's lots of standing water. So we're asking people to stay off the roads.
All right. That is always good advice in a situation like this, is to be able to, at this point now, we're looking at just tremendous amounts of rain coming down in a short period of time. So now that we have the opportunity to assess this.
Currently in our area, 56 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Here's our local Doppler radar.
Thank you.
of the emergency alert system, no weather radios warning alarm, and a special communications test for dissemination of tsunami warning messages. Also, if you are participating in today's statewide earthquake drill as part of the West Coast Great Shakeout exercise, drop, cover, and hold, and follow your post-earthquake drill procedures. This is only a test. The following tones will conclude this test.
Has been kind of a really unusual season for Hawaii.
Yeah, sometimes you get tropical threats to Hawaii, but right. This year we've had
not only his production, but as I talked about earlier, when you lose a big time producer like that, you lose leadership, a voice, someone who can stand up in the locker room.
Cookie with him tonight. Hello, you all.
The National Weather Service in Louisville has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for southwestern Franklin County in east central Kentucky, northeastern Anderson County in east central Kentucky, until 9:45 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. At 9:11 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm was located near Frankfort, moving southwest at 10 miles per hour. Expected hazards include 60 miles per hour wind gusts and penny-sized hail. This is a radar indicated threat. The following impacts are expected. Expect damage to roofs, siding, and trees. Locations impacted include Frankfort, Lawrenceburg, Alton, Broadville Manor, Capital City Airport, Bridgeport, Avenstock, Evergreen, and Farmdale. For your protection, move to an interior room on the lowest floor of a building. Report severe weather to local law enforcement. Post your report to the National Weather Service Louisville Facebook page, or tweet your report using hashtag LMKSpotter. Torrential rainfall is occurring with this storm and may lead to flash flooding. Do not drive your vehicle through flooded roadways.
There's Williams again.
This message is for test purposes only. The National Weather Service in Northern Indiana has issued a "This is a test message." Tornado warning for Elkhart County, Indiana, Wabash County, Indiana, Noble County in northeastern Indiana, Grant County in central Indiana, Woodley County in northeastern Indiana, Huntington County in northeastern Indiana, Kosciuszko County, Indiana, Cass County, Indiana, Lugren County in northeastern Indiana, LaPorte County in northwestern Indiana, Steuben County in northeastern Indiana, Allen County in northeastern Indiana, White County in northwestern Indiana, St. Joseph County, Indiana, Blackford County in east central Indiana, DeKalb County in northeastern Indiana, Glasgow County in northwestern Indiana, Fulton County, Indiana, Wells County in northeastern Indiana, Adams County in northeastern Indiana, Jay County in east central Indiana, Stark County in northwestern Indiana, Miami County, Indiana, Marshall County, Indiana. This is a test message. Until 7:45 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, or 6:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time, this is a test message. If this was an actual tornado warning, you would be given information about the location and movement of the storm. This is a test message. No severe weather is occurring. This test tornado warning is being issued as part of Indiana Severe Weather Preparedness Week. If this were an actual warning, you would be given information about the location and path of the storm and safe actions to take. This is a test message. At this time, please review your tornado preparedness plans. This is a test message. Do not take action based on this message. Repeating, a tornado warning has been issued until 7:45 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time or 6:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time for the following counties in Indiana: Adams, Allen, Blackford, DeKalb, Elkhart, Fulton.
Jaguars? No, Jaguars are...
Your professional styling fee is free.
Your own personal style.
Tornado emergency for Allsboro, Minot, Maud, and Red Rock. The National Weather Service in Huntsville has issued a tornado warning for southwestern Colbert County in northwestern Alabama until 6:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 5:41 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed large and destructive tornado was observed near Tishomingo State Park, moving east at 45 miles per hour. Tornado emergency for Allsboro, Minot, Maud, and Red Rock. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Hazard, deadly tornado. Source, radar confirmed tornado. Impact, you are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris may be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely, and complete destruction is possible. Locations impacted include Cherokee, Red Rock, Malone, Posey Loop, Minot, Mount Hesher, Strigley Church, New Bethel, Crooked Oak, and Maud. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If in a mobile home, a vehicle, or outdoors, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. Heavy rainfall may hide this tornado. Do not wait to see or hear the tornado. Take cover now. A large and extremely dangerous tornado is on the ground. Take immediate tornado precautions. This is an emergency situation. Repeating, a tornado warning has been issued until 6:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time for the following county, Colbert, Alabama.
This is the Maryland Emergency Management Agency with the coordinated test of the emergency alert system. Broadcasters are testing equipment used to warn you during an emergency. This concludes the test of the emergency alert system.
This is a test of the emergency alert system. In an emergency, this system would bring you important information. The following tones will conclude this test.
This is NORCOM 911, serving Northeast King County, with a required monthly test of the emergency alert system. In the event of an emergency, this system would bring you important information. The following tones will conclude this test.
La Roche-Posay.